All right, and we're good. Okay, so I'm going to try to make a video so those who couldn't make it can get all this information.
This bread is to die for.
Sorry. Carrie's bread is to die for, everyone. Okay, so we're going to start with, if you got the second page of the agenda, we're going to start with a portal refresher. And I'm only doing this because I noticed some, like, the same, like, mistakes or, like, misuse of the portal that I just want to, you know, refresh, help everybody kind of. And also, the software team is constantly doing phases and updates to make the portal better and more user-friendly. So there are some things that I want to update you guys on. So if you, first of all, one thing that I've noticed a couple repeat instances is if you go to your My Classes page and you are trying to request a sub, you're kind of trying to get a sub request, a lot of times people are just accidentally clicking on the wrong class to get subbed out, and I don't know what the issue is, but if you just click on that calendar up there and scroll down, then you can, you know, you choose, like, say you need it in you know, December, you know, you click December, and then you click, you know, the 25th, you're not going to be here, we'll be closed anyway, but anyway, that's what you do to get whichever class you want subbed out, okay? It really puts me in a panic when you click the wrong class to get subbed out, because usually it's like the next day, especially if it's Laurie's 6 a.m. yoga and you accidentally click tomorrow's class to get it subbed out, then I'm like, oh God, it's in that 24-hour period and I'm sweating bullets to try and find a sub, okay? So let's just make sure you're clicking on the right day you need to get subbed. Another thing that you can do, and this is about to change your lives, okay, to pay attention, if you go to instructor, and then you're going to click instructors, you can, I'm going to just show you on mine, you click view instructors, and then you can click edit, and scroll down, you can click which branches you teach at, and it even says determines which emails you get, okay, and you can click which categories you teach so that you're not getting bombarded with cycle emails when you don't teach cycle. We're trying to avoid people from just seeing the emails come through and just deleting them because they're bombarding your inbox. I do it sometimes. It's overwhelming. So if you click on, if you go to this and click edit, go to instructors, click, go to the instructors tab, click instructors, okay, find your name and click edit, you can edit your page. I would even encourage you under certifications, put what certifications you teach, and someone pointed out the other day, put when your BSS expires here. So that you know it. I know, someone else thought that, and I was like, that's a great idea, because I can keep up with, like, I've sent you guys when you expire, I can see it on my end, like, I'll show you what it looks like on my end. I click instructor, and I go to certifications, but see, you guys, y'all don't have that certifications tab on yours. So then I can click, who said, Laurie, you said
me.
Okay. Let's see when Laurie expires. You might need to stay an extra 2 hours. click. And you do. So you expire at the end of this month. So I would stay today and do your in-person.
Oh, I can't. I'll stay the next.
Yeah.
The next one.
So see, I can keep up with it on my end, but you guys don't have that. That's just because I have manager access. That's just what I have. Okay? So, everybody got that? Edit your own profile. It will be better for you. The other thing I want to point out is our reference materials tab. So, you click instructor. You go to go to reference materials. This is where a lot of non-changing policies and procedures type stuff is going to live. Okay? So, we all forget how to go about signing up for VSS every year. I do. I have to literally go here and refresh it because it's so, you know, complicated. So, if you need to reference that, scroll down and click how to register for VSS and CAP right here. You click on it and it's going to give you the instructions, okay, on how to do that. So I'll tell you, we coordinators have the ability to put reference materials up. So what's been happening is, you know, a coordinator from Simmons is like, oh, you know, my instructors, you know, every year forget how to do BSS and CAP, and we all association-wide have to do it, so we're just going to throw a instructions, you know, document on the portal and let it live here. So that's kind of what this reference materials tab is for, okay? That way you don't have to wait for an email to come from me saying, here it is, you can already get there, okay? The other thing I want to point out that is very important that lives here on reference materials is your 2018 continuing education calendar. So in my weekly emails that I send you out, usually on Mondays, sometimes it's another day, but usually on Mondays, I tell you guys, hey, we've got new courses on the CEC, you know, website. I'm getting it from right here. This link right here, you click that link, and notice, coupon code right there, YOGC is going to be your coupon code that you will need when you register for a class. It's YMCA Greater Charlotte. That's what it stands for. Here is where they live. Okay? These are all the upcoming CEC workshops. So to register, it's going to say, are you a YMCA Greater Charlotte employee? You click yes, and then hit next, and it's going to ask you which one. Oh, sorry. The first step is that you click which one you're gonna register for. Okay? So just to point out, we have quite a few. And Laurie Pace says, okay, what branches want to host? I say, Lake Norman will host anything so that it's easier for you guys to attend it. Yes. Okay?
Thank you.
The first one coming up that's at our branch, now again, obviously you can take any of these, right? I'm super excited about this. Aqua Hit, of course, I won't be here. I won't be here, but you did. You registered. Good. Aqua Hit and Floating Circuits.
Are they just running back to back?
Yeah.
Because the floating circuit, I don't think, was on there initially.
Yep, it's going to be back-to-back on September 8th. I'm so bummed I'm not.
I got to get registered for the other one.
Yeah, okay. Yep, so, sorry, those aren't at Lake Norman, but I just was excited about those and wanted to point them out. How to Coach Healthy Eating is going to be at Lake Norman. That's going to be on October 10th in this room, 10:30 to 12:30. I'm going to be there. I think it's going to be a great workshop because we run into, people want to know, well, what do you eat? What do you do? You know, and within our scope of practice, we can't, you know, because we're not a registered dietitian, we have to be very careful about what we say to people. But this is going to help us, be able what to say. That workshop is going to help us be able to coach healthy eating without breaking any rules. Okay? We also have Ortho Upper and Ortho Lower come to Lake Norman both Saturdays, but that's two Saturdays in a row, 10/27 and 11/3, which this is the same day as the Metric Century Ride. Didn't think that one through, but anyway.
Just the insert on the Ortho, like the name is not really super exciting and fun, but they are fantastic.
Okay.
And I did the Ortho Lower at Harris Y a couple of months ago, and I'm signed up for the Ortho Upper. It helps. If you're a personal trainer, if you're a yoga teacher, if you're a Pilates teacher, if you're a massage therapist, you will learn something from that to apply to your class. Those guys are fantastic.
That's what I had to cancel when I was in the hospital.
Yeah, this education stuff is really good, and a Y person who's been here for a long time, the Y trainings of the past were mediocre to poor. This is not that.
It's different.
And the fact that we can take these classes
for free. And you get paid.
And you get,
yes. Yeah. You get paid.
So, but the fact is, this is good, time accessible.
You are supposed to email me.
That's on video, Tara.
I know. I know.
Yeah, but I would like to.
I know it.
I've never been paid for
You get.
That's just part of the job. But the fact that this is free and accessible, you all should do this. Every single one.
You get up to 10 hours of CEC, of paid CEC time each year. So if you want to attend more than 10 hours, okay, it's just free. But still, you can do 10.
Oh, I thought our cutoff was 10. They didn't let you take
them. No.
Okay, got it.
You can take as many of these classes as you want.
You just get paid for 10.
It's really fantastic, guys. This is part of our healthy living investment plan that took place. Remember last November when I was having y'all sign all those, you know, this is the healthy living investment
plan. This really is good because this is stuff we normally have to pay.
I know. The YMCA said, you know what? If we see that our instructors want to work for us and they're investing in the YMCA, we're going to invest back in you. So that's the idea of all this, okay? Okay, on to my next thing. I want to point out how important this is going to be. You have a question?
So when we do, like I did the CEC and then just still sent it to you. You don't get a copy of when we go and put it in our file or anything, right? We still have to take that step so that you have documentation
right.
for our
That's correct. I don't just automatically get it. Yeah.
That's what I assume.
So her question was, so Christy went to like one of these CEC workshops and she got a little certificate that said she'd attended. Her question was, do I just automatically receive that or do I need to email it to you to put it in my file that I have in my, I don't automatically receive it. So if you want to send it to me, that's helpful. Okay. You don't, just to touch on that, it used to be a requirement that you had to get so many CECs every year. To clear that up, the YMCA requires that you get at least one CEC, just one. I mean, I don't even know that they offer a CEC that's just for one credit, but we're saying we just want you to go to at least one class, one course over the course of, you know, however long your certification lasts. Usually it's 2 years for ACE and for AFA, that says, I am staying up to speed with what's going on in my format that I teach, okay? So Carrie teaches cycle and she teaches yoga. So she needs to do at least one class that keeps her up to speed on cycle and one that keeps her up to speed on all the latest and greatest in yoga, okay? Does that make sense? Any more questions about that?
How do you know what the CCs like go for your national certification? You know, like how many CCs? CC?
It will say it.
Okay.
It will say it on there. Yeah. No, it doesn't right now.
Okay.
But when you,
okay.
Yeah, I just did one. I wish I had it. But
when you click on the thing for like the detailed information,
it'll
tell
you.
That's right. Yeah, it'll tell you how many for AFA, for NASM, for ACE. How many CECs you get. So the next thing I want to move to is this consistency is key to success. Okay, this is big. It's our 7-part Group X series. It's going to be at the Harris Y on Saturday, October 13th. Okay, what this is our association has been doing a lot of work around creating templates for all the different formats that we offer at the YMCA. Okay? Hold on, Nancy. Hold on, Nancy. Okay. This is why this is why we're doing this. In the past, there are 19 different YMCA YMCAs in the greater, in the YMCA of Greater Charlotte Association, okay? So in the past, you could go to Lowe's Y and take Total Strength, and then you could go all the way to the other side of Charlotte to Ballantyne and take Total Strength, and they looked nothing alike. They were very different. What we are in the process of doing is creating a template of, okay, if you teach Total Strength for the YMCA, this is what every Total Strength class should include. You know, a 5 to 10 minute warm up. And then you should include, you know, 10 minutes of weights, 10 minutes of whatever, you know, so that there is some structure to what that class looks like. Okay? We are not saying, we are not trying to, you know, copy and paste our instructors. We want your personality and your own personal, you know, kind of flair to the class to shine. Okay, we're not trying to take out the sparkle or the spice, because that's what makes our classes so fabulous. But when it comes to the nuts and bolts of the class, there needs to be consistency there in what we're offering across the board. And here is why. In the past 10 years, the YMCA out of the YMCA of Greater Charlotte membership has declined by 2% in the past 10 years. So our association has gone, okay, we're not doing something right. We need to fix it. I mean, now more than ever, we have competition. We have Pure Bar, we have CrossFit, we have Cycle Bar, we have CrossFit Cornelius, CrossFit Davidson, CrossFit Huntersville. I mean, we have so much competition out there, and they've done a ton of research, and we actually created and hired a new person at the association level just to crunch numbers and do data analysis. And what they found was that we're lacking consistency in what we're offering. Think of it this way. When you go to Starbucks, raise your hand if you have like a go-to drink that you get at Starbucks. Okay? And you know, Mark, if you go to the Starbucks in Huntersville or if you go to the Starbucks in Mooresville, if you get that, you know, tall chai latte, whatever, it's going to taste the same. And that's what's so beautiful about Starbucks, is it doesn't matter. You know what you're going to get. We will never be as structured as a Starbucks or a Chick-fil-A because of the nature of our organization. However, think of that mentality when we're talking about these templates. People want consistency, okay? So, all of this consistency is key to success, the 7-part group up series. There will be 7 different workshops that you can attend. One's going to be probably Total Strength, the main ones that we offer now. Total Strength, there's going to be Pilates Core, there's going to be the main, you know, I don't know that they're doing yoga yet. What I want you guys to do is attend the one that you teach, okay? And then the rest, you can go to some that you're like, well, I teach water fitness right now, but I think I might like to teach Pilates. I think I'm going to attend that one too, okay? It's going to be, has anyone ever been to a group fitness expo before where it's sort of like a half a day thing and you get to, it's fun and you get your workout in, you learn a ton of stuff. So Saturday, October 13th, from 12 to 7 at the Harris Y. Registration will open on September 1st, okay? And it will fill up quick, okay? So put an alarm or something on your phone, like I had to do for my Hamilton tickets. Lord have mercy. That I got some in Durham, though. I'm going to Durham, but I'm seeing that Hamilton tag on it. Yes, I woke up at 5 a.m. in that virtual waiting room. Anyway, put it on your calendars, okay, for September 1st to register, okay?
So how will sign-ups go? Will they fill up?
They may very well. I don't know how many. We're going to, Laurie Pace is going to try to get as many people as we can fit into the Harris Y.
So that one is like an expo?
It is an expo, where you'll be learning. All right.
So it says mandatory on there.
It does. It says yes. And where?
On your agenda.
Oh. Okay, I didn't know that. But it's highly, highly encouraged. Okay. I mean, I don't use the term mandatory because I can't physically make you.
Is there a cost? These expos usually cost nothing.
I think I remember it saying something about being mandatory if you would like to be educator, like if we want to teach.
Right. Yes. If you wanted to, you know, yeah. Let me get clarification on if you can go for part.
I have a list of like what.
Right. I feel like, you know, yes, yeah. I feel like that would be the answer, but let me get clarification. Okay.
One more interjection on this education.
Yes.
Thing.
Thank you so much.
You want to have like the Christy show or the hand power hour yoga. It's like consistency makes sense. Right?
Thank you, Christy, for saying that because I did want to include you guys. Some of you all may have received an email. I know some like Norman people, Laurie reached out to and asked for input on these templates. Okay, so this comes, the templates that we've created are coming from our YMCA of Greater Charlotte instructors, okay? And what's even more exciting about this is it's just a really fun time to be an instructor at the YMCA because these CEC workshops that we're having are taught by you guys, a lot of them. We've taken really successful, you know, tier 4 yoga instructors or whatever, you know, people who clearly through their attendance numbers and through word of mouth have, you know, are getting, you know, having success and saying, okay, what are you doing right? And let's, you know, come teach a workshop for the rest of us. And I want you guys to start thinking about potentially leading a workshop. If you feel like you've done this for 30 years and gosh, I may have learned a couple of things then, you know? Here's how you do that, okay? So we've got, this is our CEC, how you register. And where does it live? On the portal, under which tab? Reference materials. Okay.
You passed.
So is that where we're going to go to sign up for that expo?
That's correct. And what I've been doing, guys, is in my weekly emails, I pretty much just copy and paste that link to y'all. But I want you to know that it lives here so that you can access it whenever. You don't have to just be sitting waiting for my email. Because at some point, you guys will just go to the portal. Like, I may not, you know, I like the weekly emails because I feel like it informs you guys of just what's going on at Lake Norman during this week, you know. And I've gotten feedback that I think you guys like getting the weekly updates emails just to say, okay, what's going on? But anyway, I just want you to know that you don't have to wait around for me to access that. It's here, okay? The other thing that also lives here on the reference materials tab is the Healthy Living Staff Development Portal. I told the Monday night people, we are overusing the word portal. But just know, healthy living investment, that's going to be how you get reimbursed for your certification. So for me, I just had to renew my AFA certificate, my AFA Group X certification. This is where I went to do that. Okay? So that you have to pay for it yourself first. You've got to pay $99 for me. Send it off. Yeah, keep your receipt. And then when you get your updated certification, that's when you go to get your reimbursement, and you will get a check in the mail.
I just did it on you, there.
Yep, and
so
I've got
really
it.
Easy.
I got it, and I'm wearing the
I didn't expect it to be that easy.
Yes.
I was waiting for it.
Yeah, yeah. So this, when you click, again, reference materials, you're going to click on, you're going to scroll down to find Healthy Living Staff Development Portal, okay? It talks about all the five areas of staff investment. You can, you've got tier advancement, Healthy Living Scholarship. That's like if you are a water fitness instructor and you want to, you're like, I kind of want to teach land and do cycle. You could apply for us to reimburse you for that. Typically, we reimburse for whatever you have to meet your job requirements. So sometimes that's like Brian Strahine teaches just spinning. So he paid for his spinning recertification, and we reimburse him for that because that's all he teaches. Does that make sense? If you, if like he subs every now and then for yoga, but we're not going to reimburse for yoga when he's not, when that's not his main job. Does that make sense? Okay. So you're going to scroll down and click on this little link here. Staff Development Portal, and look, there's the CEC course registration link. Again, we've got it kind of everywhere on this. So this is what comes up. You're going to click, if you're doing reimbursement, you're going to do educational reimbursement and literally click through there. And like Marnie said, it's very user-friendly, right? Mm-hmm. Real easy.
Suppose you save, like I have a receipt to my email, save this PDF.
Right,
and then
right.
Just put it all in there.
Yeah, just save. Yeah, save your receipt as a PDF, save your certification as a PDF, and then you can just upload it right in here so that we see, oh, yep, she's done her job. Okay? I'm trying, golly Pete, we went a little bit over. I'm trying to fly through the rest of this. Can I just borrow your? Okay. I have on here emphasize the importance of the weekly updates email. I say that just because I have gotten a couple of questions that I answer in those emails. So please just pay attention to them. Make sure you read them. It just gives me peace of mind to know that I'm just all about communication, right? If you are reading those emails, then I feel like, okay, I've done my job in telling them what's going on and what's coming up and all that. We are in the process, our association, Group X coordinators at all of the 19 branches, we're getting together and creating a policies and procedures manual. You know, through the years, things have changed. And sometimes, you know, it used to be that you had to attend, you know, the requirements for attending meetings was this many. And we're just, all of us coordinators are like, well, what do you require of your instructors at your branch? Well, I'll tell them to do this, but what do you do at your branch? We're like, let's get on the same page of what our policies and procedures are. So we're in the process. That would include, like, it would be like a handbook. We just can't use the word handbook because HR has the handbook, and they don't want us using that word. So we're creating a policies and procedures manual, okay? And it will include, like, for Lake Norman, it will vary slightly from branch to branch. But, like, for us, if you no-show for a class, 30-day, you're off the schedule. You can't teach, okay? So our manual would include that in there. It would include your sub-requirements, what you're required to do, you know, how many times you're required to sub. Stuff like that, that if you have questions, like, we have something on paper, okay? Okay, I have one last thing, and it is 12:02. Can I ask 3 minutes of you all?
Yeah.
Okay, I hate keeping people over time, but we went just a tidbit longer than we did on Monday. So 3 minutes, we'll start with 12:06, you guys can walk out whether I'm done or not, okay? All right. And when 1 year passes, we look over what were the highlights of the years of last year. It just, I don't know, I love goals and seeing how far we've come and then things to work on, okay? I just wanted to show you all this. This is for Lake Norman, okay? The blue is, the purple is 2017 group fitness attendance. So how many people coming through our doors were going to group fitness? The blue is 2018, and as you can see, we are trending higher in 2018 than we were in 2017. So kudos to y'all. I think that's exciting, and we just want to continue that. 80% of people that walk through our doors are coming here for fitness, for a fitness-related thing. When you think of the Lake Norman, or when you think of the YMCA, what do you think about? I think of a gym. Okay, they have group fitness classes. They have a place that I can go work out, okay? Yeah, they have camp and all that other stuff, but primarily people that are coming through our doors come for fitness. So we just want to continue to make our group fitness program the place where people are coming, okay? This is other graph stuff, and you can see, I'll just show you this one real quick. This shows you all the branches in our association, and you can kind of tell by the graph how we should be, like who we should be kind of comparing ourselves to, so based on branch size. So Brace, Dowd, Harris, Morrison, those are like our largest branches in the Y, okay? And you can see blue is some of group attendance land, some of group attendance water, some of combined attendance, and then some of attendance with a 10% goal of growth. Okay? For Lake Norman, we are pretty consistent with Lowe's, Sarah's Y, the Keith family Y. So as you can see, our combined attendance is kind of trending high compared to those. So, did my time to the time? Okay, all right. Put your attendance numbers in. It's important so that we get data. Okay, you can go. Thank you all. Thank you all so much for coming. I appreciate you, and you guys are amazing.
Tara, I cannot come today.